বলো হরি নাম সংকীর্তনে তুমি কৃপা করি শ্রদ্ধা বিন্দু দিয়া
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 দেহ কৃষ্ণ নাম ধনে তোমার চকতি আছে আমি তো কাম
Thank you. I told you, yeah. And I go, but I'm here now, I'm here.
What are you doing?
因为他自己嘛，那个布施呢，家里不知道吗？
sadadhar shivasabu gola sabrumba jaya puru krishna chaitanya prabhu nityananda shri advaita sadadhar
कल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपासिन्धुभ्यैव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमो महावदनाय कृष्णप्रेमप्रदायते कृष्णाय कृष्णचैतन्य नाम्ने गौरत्वजे गुरवे गौरचन्द्राय राधिकाय सदालयै कृष्णाय कृष्णभक्ताय तद्भक्ताय यं प्रव्रजन्तमनुपेतमपेतकृत्यं द्वैपायनो विरहकातरया जुहाव पुत्रेति तन्मयतया सर्वोऽभिनेव तं सर्वभूतहृदयम् तवैवास्मि न जीवामि त्वया विना इति विज्ञाय राधे फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल माई हम्बल ओबेसियंसेज इन द लोटस फीट ऑफ माई स्पिरिचुअल मास्टर नित्य लीला प्रविष्ट विष्णु पार कृष्ण भक्ति प्रज्ञान केशव गोस्वामी एंड सैम इन द लोटस फीट ऑफ नित्य लीला प्रविष्ट ओम विष्णु पार कृष्ण भक्ति के दान स्वामी महाराज
首先我向我的灵性导师尼特利拉普利萨欧米迪斯尼塔阿斯特萨特西西玛巴克利丹克西普加拉黑斯摩克萨尼的莲哈图平台同样我也向呢尼特利拉普利萨欧米迪斯尼塔阿斯特西西玛巴克利丹克双米马拉斯的莲哈图平台
As we are giving classes on Srimad Bhagavatam that really if a man wants to be happy in this world and transcendental world, they should follow pure devotion of Supreme Lord Krishna. And whatever is to go to please only Krishna. Especially, this would be very tolerant. There are so many obstacles in bhakti marg. But we should not be ghabrana nahi chaliye. Not disturb. Always engaged in bhakti. In Srimad Bhagavati it has been told that there was a father and there was a son. And father wanted to kill his son. He gave fire. He wanted to give him the elephant teeth. Poison flowing from mountains and so many. He wanted to bind him. Why? But he could not do. Why we are going to speak all these things? And I think that if you will follow the life history of Prahlad Maharaj, you must be a high class of devotee.
那么我们在追寻奉爱的这个路途中的话呢，要非常的包容，因为在法体在奉爱这条路上呢是有很多呢艰难险阻的，但是我们总应该坚持在呢这个奉献服务之中。在顺典菩萨法堂中提到了有一父亲和一儿子，那么父亲呢想试图想杀死儿子，那么他把呢儿子呢放在火里面，给他的食物下毒，把他从悬崖上扔下来，并且放在油锅里面。 但他呢却发不了他，为什么呢？所以我们今天讨论呢这些命题，那么在追随呢普拉达大行的这个路途中的话呢，我们就可以学习到这些呢品质。
But I want that we should discuss this. I want to come in Krishna pastime.
Om Jnana Chirandasya Jnananjana Salakaya Chakshuranilitam Jena Tasmai Sri Gurave Namaha. So now Sri Gurudev is beginning to unfold the transcendental history of the great devotee Prahlad Maharaj.
那么现在呢，哈，除了古典，还要展开呢，哈，这个伟大的复兴者，所以Prahlad Maharaj，哈，这个故事。
There is a very great narration in the 7th canto of Srimad Bhagavatam in many chapters describing this history of Prahlad Maharaj.
那么在圣典国家瓦堂的第七篇里面有很多篇章描述到了这一段的故事。
But we will describe briefly those teachings and the history.
那么我们非常简略的就是讲述了这段故事以及在其中的报道。
So Prahlad Maharaj, he was the son of a very demoniac father who was very, very powerful.
那么那普拉达呢？马哈拉什的话呢，是一个哈非常邪恶的哈，也是呢非常有力量的这么一个哈为恶魔的这个儿子。
This took place many, many millions and millions of years ago, toward the beginning of our universe.
那么这段故事呢，发生在呢哈数以百亿哈百万年哈前的，那么是在一直追溯到哈我们宇宙的创造之时的。
So Prahlad Maharaj's father's name was Hiranyakashipu.
那么普拉达大君哈，他的父亲的名字呢叫呢 Hiranyakashipu。
Hiranya means gold, and Kashipu means soft wood.
那么呢哈 ，Hiranya 的意思呢是黄金哈，那么呢 Kashipu 哈是呢柔软的船。
What this means is that the ordinary materialistic person in this world, he thinks that the ultimate goal of all life is to have money and sense gratification.And sleep in soft bed and enjoy all of these kind of mundane pleasures.
那么哈，一般的物质主义者的话呢，哈，都认为哈，在这个世界上哈，城市里面呢，哦，有钱哈，有黄金啊，有钱，并且呢哈，享受这个物质的快乐啊，包括呢哈，在柔软的床上哈，睡觉等等的哈，那么都是哈，他们所追求的。
So this person Hiranyakashipu, he was very, very determined.To become extremely powerful. In fact, he wanted to control the entire universe. He wanted that kind of power.
所以的话呢，希望亚克西普哈，他呢就就说呢，他想哈，他非常坚定的哈，想要呢控制的哈整个宇宙，他想要这种的哈权力。
And actually, he wanted to become immortal, that he would never have to die.
那么他甚至想追求哈永生呢，就是永远的哈不会死的。
So with this objective.Hiranyakashipu, he went to this mountain called Mandara Mountain, and he began to perform very severe austerities.
那么金怀这个意图了，那么Hiranyakashipu哈去到了 Mandara 哈这个山上呢，去然后做非常严厉的苦行。
Because by this process he wanted to please Lord Brahma and to call Lord Brahma to come and give him benediction.
因为他急着哈苦行呢，想了哈呼唤呢主普拉玛，啊那普拉玛来到的时候呢哈，他想要这个祝福。
Lord Brahma is the topmost living entity in the universe.
那么主 Brahma 呢，被称为哈整个物质宇宙，这个物质宇宙里面哈最高的这个生物体。
So he was thinking that if he could perform austerities, then Lord Brahma could give him what he wants.
他觉得哈，我如果呢做苦修的话呢，哈苦行的话呢，那么主 Brahma 哈可以赐我哈，就是他的哈所有的东西。
So he went to this place and he began to stand on the tips of his toes with his arms upraised in the air without moving.
那么呢，他在山上的时候呢，做一种苦修的话，就是说呢，在指甲啊，在脚趾哈，脚掌啊，脚趾那个脚趾的尖的话呢，啊，点地，然后呢，双手啊，手然后往上去。
If we try to do that, if we try to do, we can do for a few seconds or minutes, but he did it for many thousands of years.
那么我们如果做这种姿势的话呢，哈，顶多呢是几秒钟哈，几分钟才了不得了。那么呢，他呢却做了哈几千年。
At that time, the human beings could live for up to 100,000 years.
那么那时候呢，人们寿命的话是十万年的。
So Hiranyakashipu, he was standing in this pose, and ants began to eat all around his body, and eventually they ate all his skin, his muscle, and only the bone was left there.
那么 Hiranyakashipu 哈在呢，就是说脚趾脚趾点地哈，这样子的一个姿势呢，站立的话呢，当时哈，这个蚂蚁也都把它的肉和皮哈都吃了，最后呢，只剩下骨头。
But he was so determined and powerful, even in the skeleton, his living force remained.
那么当时的话，他非常的哈，这个坚决的，所以呢，这种时候的话呢，他将这个灵魂哈，收入了这个骨髓里面哈。
And the demigods of the higher planetary systems were watching, and they were becoming very frightened that oh, he's becoming so powerful.So they requested Lord Brahma to come there.
那么当时高等星宿的半神呢，哈，目击了这种苦行呢，哈，觉得呢，哈，非常的就不安的哈，他们就请求主 Brahma 哈。
So Lord Brahma came there, and he came on his swan chariot. When Hiranyakashipu saw him, actually Lord Brahma, he poured water from his water pot, Kamandalu, on the head of Hiranyakashipu, and his bones, and suddenly he became very beautiful, powerful body.
那么当时呢，主布拉玛哈就骑着他的这个天鹅的坐骑哈就飞来了，然后他用他的哈这个壶啊圣水哈洒到了他的身上的话呢，他立即获得哈一个呢很漂亮的完美的这个肉身。
And then Hiranyakashipu paid his obeisances to Lord Brahma.
那么这时候呢，Hiranyakashipu哈向了主布拉玛的敬拜。
Brahma said, what benediction do you desire?
So Brahma 说, 你想要什么样的祝福?
And Hiranyakashipu said, oh, I want to become immortal.
他说的话, 我想永生。
And Lord Brahma said, unfortunately, I cannot give you that benediction because even I myself, although I can live for trillions of years, but even eventually I must die.
那么呢，主观上说哈，非常抱歉哈，不能给你这种祝福，因为就算是我哈，尽管他活了，能够活呢哈，数以兆亿年哈，也呢要死的。
So Hiranyakashipu thought he was very intelligent. He said, okay, then give me the benediction that I cannot die in the day or the night.
那么Hiranyakashipu哈，他就自以为很聪明了哈，他就说了，那好了，那你给我祝福哈，不要在白天，也不要在黑夜死。
And Lord Brahma said, yes, I give you that benediction.
So Brahma 说哈，那可以哈，我可以满足你哈，就给这个祝福给你。
Then he said, okay, let me not die on the land, on the sea, or in the air.
那么哈，原来师父在说了哈，他说让我呢哈，不要在陆地上，也不要在水里面，也不要在空气中哈，死掉。
Lord Brahma said, okay.
那么主 Brahma 说好。
Then he said, let me not die by any man-made weapon.
他说让我哈不被呢哈任何人所制造的武器所伤。
Okay, you agree?
好、哦，他说好。
Let me not die by any living being, man, animal, or any other living being created by you in this universe.
那么哈，让我呢不被你所创造的任何生物体所伤哈，包括人和动物。
So Lord Brahma approves of all of his requests.
所以呢哈，主 Brahma 呢同意他所有这些要求。
And then Hiranyakashipu, he'sraised his arms in the air and he said, now I am immortal!
这时候呢屁股哈就说呢高举双手他说哈我得永生了哈。
So now, Hiranyakashipu, he began to terrorize the universe because he was so powerful and he fought against the demigods, but the demigods, they simply fled from him in fear.And he occupied the position of Indra, the king of heaven. Go, they should give up this household life, this blind well, and they should go to the forest, and they should take shelter of the Supreme Lord Hari. Now there were some very deep teachings within Prahlad Maharaj's statement to his father.
所以呢在普拉达大君哈对他父亲的这个对话里面呢有很多很深刻的教导。
And our acharyas have explained to us the meaning, what he was talking about in this verse.
那么呢我们的 acharya 们哈导师们的话呢也解释到哈这些细节里面的含义。
They have given a story to explain this to us.
那么这里面哈他们举了一个故事哈来呢描述这个哈教导。
Once there was a man who was walking through the forest.
那么有一次哈有一个人呢在森林里面哈就说行走走步。
And in this jungle forest, he was very pleasantly observing the beauty of the forest.
那么他呢哈非常呢在那森林丛林里面哈他非常的高兴的哈欣赏这林中美景。
But suddenly, as he was walking in this very peaceful environment, he heard a very loud sound.
那么在这哈很平静的哈这个风景里面的话呢哈他在走着，他突然间哈听到一个哈巨声巨响。
And he turned and he saw a tiger with a huge open mouth looking at him. And when he saw the tiger, immediately he became frightened and he began running as fast as he could. And as he was running, he was looking, where can I hide?
他们一路跑呢，一路看着有没有地方可以藏身的。
And suddenly he saw that there was an old well that was covered with some grasses, and he saw that there were two branches of a tree hanging over the well.
那么呢，他走着走着，跑着跑着，看到一个枯井了，里面呢已经布满了这个杂草。那么在那旁边的话也是树枝。
So with his two arms, he held on to the two branches of the tree, and he lowered himself down halfway into the well.
那么的话，他手抓的这个树枝的话，哈，将自己呢，哈，就降到了，哈，那个井中啊，哦，降了一半。
But below him, when he looked down, he saw that the bottom of the well was filled with snakes hissing, so he had to only hang there.
那么呢哈，他往井底下一看的话呢哈，底下呢都是一些蛇哈，正在呢哈，就伸着哈，就伸着头。
And then one moment later, above him was the head of the tiger looking down at him.
哦，然后抬头一看哈，老虎呢已经到了井口旁边。
So now he's in this position. He's hanging there, holding on to the two branches of the tree. He cannot go up. He cannot go down.
所以现在他处境呢就这样子哈，在呢半拉吊着哈，又不能上又不能下。
But what makes things even worse?The two branches of the tree, he noticed that there was a rat on each branch, and it was biting and biting the branches.
那么哈，更糟糕的是呢哈，他呢手抓着这两个树枝哈，正在被两只老鼠呢哈咬着。
One rat was white color, the other was black color.
那么有只老鼠呢是黑色的，有只是白色的。
So little by little, now the branches are being eaten through by the rats.
所以的话呢，一点点的这个哈老鼠的话，这个树枝哈都被老鼠的话一点点咬开了。
So he's in this predicament.
所以他在这种的哈，这种的哈危机的状态。
But then he saw above him another thing.
然后再往上看哈，看到一样东西。
There was a beehive, and from this beehive, some honey was dripping down.
那么当时哈有个蜂巢了，那么上面的话有一些蜜哦，蜂露蜜那个蜜露哈滴下来。
And a couple drops of honey were dripping just in front of his face.
那么呢，这几滴哈蜜这个蜜糖的话呢，哈刚好呢就在他眼前呢掉下来。
So when he saw the drops of honey coming, then he thought, "Oh, I should try to taste this honey."
他说呢，哎呦，这里有蜂蜜哈，他说我应该哈尝一尝这个。
And he made an effort while he was hanging there to make his tongue go out to catch the honey.
然后他呢哈就努力了哈，尽管他掉在那里哈，把舌头呢伸出去哈。
And as he stretched his neck and his tongue caught one drop of honey, he said, "Oh, how sweet!"
那么伸着舌头呢，哈，接住那么一点的哈蜂蜜了，他就说，哈，太甜了，哈，好甜。
And for a single moment, he forgot what was the condition that he was in.
所以呢，就在那么一刻钟哈里面呢，他忘记了哈他周围的哈这个危险的环境。
So what is the meaning of this story?
所以这个故事是什么意思呢？
Who is the man hanging there?
那个人哈，那个挂在那里的人哈是谁
？It is all of us.
就是我们哈，我们所有人。
In this material world.
也就身处这个物质世界的人。
Because in this material world, everyone is headed towards death.
因为在这个世界上的人的话哈，都是呢哈走向死亡的。
Who is the tiger?
谁是那只老虎
？Death personified, chasing us at every moment.
就是死的哈，人格化身哈。
No one can avoid death in this world.
没有人可以避开哈死亡。
And what are the snakes below?
那么这下面哈在那里哈的蛇是什么
？All the miseries of material existence, old age and diseases.
那么就所有哈这些物质的痛苦啊哈，老年呢，还有呢疾病等等哈来呢啊滋扰我们的。
And what are the two branches?
那两只树枝是什么
？Oh, the two branches are your duration of your life, however long you have.
那么就是你的受限哈，你有多长的命哦
？What is this well? The well that he's hanging in.
那么这个井呢是什么呢哈？它。
It is this material existence, this household life of material world of friendship and family and so on.
就是的哈，物质存在的哈，包括你的在物质世界里面的家居生活哈，你的朋友圈子等等这些东西。
And what are the two rats?
那两只老鼠呢
？That are biting on the branches.
也就是说，噬咬这个树枝的哈，那两只老鼠。
They are day and night.
就是白天和黑夜。
Because every day and every night, one more notch, one more day goes by, and our life is coming closer to the end.
因为呢哈，一天呢，一天的过去的话呢，我们生命哈已经接近了哈这个末端。
But what is the honey that is dripping there?
那么这个蜂蜜是什么？
And in that condition, he is tasting one drop of honey and forgetting all about the suffering condition.
因为呢，那时候他品尝一滴的甘露哈，那个蜂蜜的话，就能忘记他所有的问题。
That honey means the affection that we are trying to taste in this world from our loved ones, from our family, from our friends like this.
那么这个蜂蜜的话，就是我们在这世界上哈，是否从身边哈亲爱的人身上，我们的朋友啊哈，我们家人呢？身上品尝的这种爱和情感。
But tasting that honey does not change our situation one single bit.
但是的话呢，品尝这种蜂蜜呢，并不能改变我们的处境。
So therefore, Prahlad Maharaj, being a fully enlightened soul, he gave the perfect advice to his materialistic father.
所以的话，普拉德大君的话， 据说完全觉悟的人了，那么他给予他父亲是一个完美的报道。
He said, immediately, one should give up the attachments to this household life and take full shelter of Krishna.
那么他说一个人应该练习放弃的家居生活而然后去完全脱避 Krishna。
He should surrender fully to the Supreme Lord Krishna.
向至尊主 Krishna 完全的归依。
And in this way, he should attain the perfection of his life and go beyond this world of birth and death and suffering.
哦，达到了生命的完美呢，穿越了这个呢生死境
界。嗯。
OK, 谢谢。
Guru Devi, Guru Chandra, Radhe, Kaya, Tathane, Krishna, Krishna, Bhakta, Kadu, Bhakta, Namo. So first of all, I offer obeisances to Srila Gurudev, Chaitanya Sannyasis, Vaishnavas, Vaishnavis. Thank you for coming.
首先我向 Srila Gurudev, 向所有的 Chaitanya Sannyasis, 所有 Vaishnava, Vaishnava, 敬拜。
So when Hirani Kashipu heard this, he laughed. He thought it was very funny.
那么原来师父这个恶魔听了这番话的他在那笑他觉得很可笑。
Because Prahlad Maharaj was only a small child.
因为当时巴达大君还是个小毛孩。
So he didn't take it very seriously.
所以那根本他没有不当真的。
He said, "Thus is the intelligence of a child spoiled by the enemy."
他说这就是被敌人所毁掉的这个孩子他的智慧是这样。
He thought maybe some Vaishnava spy had gone into school.
他可是肯定有一些人完全让我的硬盘混在学校里面。
Just like Gurudev Sannyasis going in shirt and pants, like spies and spreading Hare Krishna, something like that.
就像 Gurudev 的一些 Sannyasis 也像硬盘一样穿入人群在传播 Krishna 世界。
So Prahlad Maharaj went back to school for re-education.
所以Prahlad 大君被送入学校要接受正当的教育。
And after some months there, he returned back to his father.And his father asked him, "What is the best thing you learned from your teacher?"
过了几个月之后，他又回到父亲那里，他父亲就在问他，你在学校里面学到最好的东西是什么？
Prahlad never considered his materialistic schoolmasters to be his guru. He really remembered the teachings of Sri Narad Muni.
Prahlad 并没有将他的物质就学校里面的老师当做他的灵性导师了，而是立即的想起他的灵性导师 Narad Muni。
Therefore, Sri Prahlad Maharaj said, Shravanam, Ketanam, Vishnu, Smaranam, Parasevanam, Archanam, Vandanam, Dasyam, Satyam, Atmanavedanam, Itipunsapita, Vishnu, Bhaktishanavadakshanam, Kretam, Bhagati, Adam, Maniti, Adita, Uttamam. O Father, I think that someone who surrenders to the two Vishnus, who completely surrenders to them, who are the two Vishnus?
那么这两位 Vishnu 是谁呢
？Someone may think, I heard there is only one God, but Prahlad Maharaj is saying there is two.
有人说了我只听过一位神，怎么 Prahlad 大君说两位了
One form of Sri Krishna is Visai Vigraha, the supreme enjoyer, Vrijananandam.
那么Krishna 的一个形象的话呢，是呢就是说呢，Visai Vigraha 就是说呢享受者至尊享受者 Krishna.
But the other form of Bhagavan is Sevak Bhagavan.
那么第二个呢Bhagavan, 我家房的第二个形象呢是 Seva Bhagavan,
the supreme enjoyer,
被称为至尊的被享受者。
That is Srimati Radhika.
那么就是呢Srimati Radhika.
And her expansion is world is Sri Guru Padma.
那么她的一个扩展呢就是呢 Sri Guru Padma.
Therefore, to the high class devotees, we respect them on Vishnu Pad. Why? They are considered to be a manifestation of the feet of Vishnu in this world.
那么呢我们尊称呢这个呢布信者为呢 Om Vishnu Pad 因为他们呢是 Krishna 这个莲花主的在这个世界的展示
We have not seen Krishna.
我们看不见 Krishna.
Therefore, Krishna comes in the form of Gurudev to deliver us from this world.
因此的Krishna 的话呢，以Sri Guru 这个形象的话来到我面前的来呢拯救我们。
Therefore, Guru is to be worshipped as good as Krishna himself.
因此的话呢一位 Guru 的话呢要当做像 Krishna 一样的崇拜。
Shakshad Harindana Samastha.All the scriptures say the spiritual master is non-different than the Supreme Lord Krishna himself.
所以呢，所有经典都指出了自尊guru 的话跟那 Krishna 的话无二无变。
Therefore, one who surrenders to the bona fide guru and under the guidance of Gurudev performs loving service to the Supreme Lord Sri Krishna.
所以呢，任何人哈，不应该一个呢哈，纯正的灵性导师哈，去雇，并且在他指导下呢哈，去你的从事呢，对 Krishna 的痛爱服务。
Completely surrendering to both of them.
然后呢，完全归于二者。
And perform the nine limbs of devotion.
那么呢，啊，进行了这个九项奉献服务的活动。
Hearing about Krishna.
聆听 Krishna.
Chanting.
唱颂他。
Remembering.
哦，冥想。
Offering prayers.
哦，向他献上祷物。
Worshipping in the temple.
啊、在神庙里面崇拜
becoming the friend of Krishna、
啊、与主为友
becoming the servant of Krishna
成为 Krishna 的仆人
and completely surrendering to him these are nine limbs of devotion one who does them under the guidance of Gurudev that person knows everything、
啊、最后呢是完全皈依自己的那么任何一个人在侮辱的指导下去从事这些服务的话呢他就、啊、已经知道一切
That is not being taught in the colleges, schools, and universities.
那么这种知识的话，在大学哈，在那些学院里面哈，并没有传授这一类型的知识。
Therefore, that is lacking.
那么这就是缺的东西哈，我们所缺的东西。
When Hirani Kashipu heard it, this is what you learn at school. He became completely furious.
那么呢，Hirani Kashipu呢哈，听了这个话哈，他说这就是你在学校学的东西哈，他完全的哈怒发冲冠。
He chastised the teachers of Prahlad Maharaj, the sons of.Shukracharya, Sandanamaka. What nonsense you're teaching my son.
那么他责骂哈这个老师了哈，就是说呢，他说你教的是什么东西给我儿子哈
？You are teaching about service to Krishna, my enemy.
他说呢，你既然教授哈对 Krishna 这个服务哈，我的敌人来的。
Sandanamaka. Amaka means blind, has no knowledge.
那么 Amaka 是哈瞎子哈。
And Sanda means fool.Because bull eats so much, pass a stool, that's his life. He drink and be merry.
那么三打的话呢，可以说呢是牛哈，就牛呢只吃哈，又睡哈，就是说是这样子过一辈子的哈。
Therefore, all materialistic teachers are all like that, blind and stupid.
那么所有的哈物质主义的这个老师的哈，都是这样子的哈，他自己是瞎的，而且呢很有蠢哈。
They began shaking. We did not teach him this. We don't know where he got it from.
那么老师的话在那里的话发抖了哈，他说呢我们没有教他这些东西哈，不知道他从哪里学来的。
Prahlad, where you got this knowledge from?
他说哈，哦 Prahlad 哈，你从哪里学来这些东西
？Prahlad said, What can I say? They cannot control their senses. Those who cannot control their senses, they cannot practice spiritual life.
那些哈控制不了感官的人的话呢，他是不能够进行哈灵性生活的。
Their inclination to Krishna is not aroused by others.
那么他们的哈这种呢对 Krishna 的倾向哈是不能够被别人的唤醒的。
The cow began running.
那么当他抓住那个母牛的尾巴的时候，母牛就受恐吓了哈，他就开始跑。
The blind man he was too afraid to let go of the tail of the cow.
那么这瞎子呢哈也害怕呢，也紧抓不放哈，就呢没有放手。
The cow was kicking him, passing stool on him.
然后呢这个母牛呢哦一边跑呢哈边呢就有拉屎拉尿哈，给他又踢他哈。
He was going into trees, falling into holes, being dragged through the mud, but he would not let go of the tail of the goat.
那么这只母牛呢，就是说冲到那个树林里面，冲到坑里面去，还呢跑到那林子里面，它还是紧抓不放。
After great suffering, he came to the village finally.
最后呢，受尽苦头了，回到村里面。
Then his own family members couldn't recognize him. Hey, this guy is stealing our cow. They began beating him.
哦，家里人也认不出他了哈，说呢，哎呦，这个家伙竟然偷我们家的牛哈，然后呢拿棍子哈打他。
So people are like that. They choose a false guru in this world and they hang on to the end. So much suffering, but no benefit.
所以呢哈，世上的人也是这样哈，选了个假的guru哈，去了一辈子哈，就是说呢坚守着他，最后呢受尽苦头。
Hirani Kashipu became very angry. You think you know more than me?
Hirani Kashipu 很生气哈，他说呢，你以为哈你比我知道的更多
？Are you better at me than controlling your senses?
你比我更好的控制感官吗
？Are you more than my guru Shukracharya?
是不是比我的灵性老师哈 Shukracharya 还要高
？How come you can know this and I cannot know this?
怎么回事呢？你既然能知道这些，而我却不知道。
I have also performed austerities. I also have knowledge of the scriptures.
我也哈从事苦修了哈，我也有经典的知识。
I'm also handsome, wealthy.
我也长得很英俊哈，我也很有钱。
Prahlad said this is not enough, father.
那么 Prahlad 大君说哈，他说哦，父亲哈，这还不够。
Unless nation must be starved of economy, unless one is fallen at the feet of a pure devotee.
除非一个人哈。 制定哈，一个纯粹奉献者的图像，也就是你拜在他头上。
Who is completely free from all material attachment and obstacles？
那么这种灵性导师哈，免于所有的哈物质欲望和所有的障碍。
Felicity means touch the feet。
哦，那么这个词语哈，代表呢触碰的哈莲花主。
And completely taken the foot dust on the head.And completely bathe oneself with the foot dust of such a spiritual master.
然后呢，完全沐浴在哈这样的一位灵性导师哈这个足下尘土。
One's mind can never be attracted towards Krishna.
那么不然的话呢，一个人的心意是不会呢受 Krishna 所吸引。
Hiranyakashipu became very angry.
那么 Hiranyakashipu 哈怒不可遏。
This Prahlad is like an axe. Now he's like a thorn tree.
那么哈这个 Prahlad 哈就像一个呢哈有刺的树一样。
Vishnu is like the axe.
然后呢 ，Vishnu 哈像一个呢哈斧头。
Because the thorn tree is very good wood for making a handle of an axe.
因为呢哈这个有刺哈那种树的话呢，是做那个斧头啊，这个柄呢是很好的哈，硬很坚硬的木头。
They will cut down the forest of the sandalwood trees of the demons.
他说呢哈，他们将砍倒哈这个呢恶魔家族哈这个檀香树哈。
Even though you are my own son, I must finish you.
他说呢哈，尽管你是我儿子哈，我也要把你杀掉。
Just like if there's this gangrene in the small finger, you cut off a finger to save your hand. Gangrene.
Gangrene. 哦，那么如果哈这个呢手的话呢哈快死了，那么就要砍掉哈。
I must kill him.
那么他说哈，我一定要把他哈杀了。
He ordered the demons chop him, pierce him, poison him, pound him, finish him.
那么他呢哈命令这些恶魔哈把他砍了哈，把他呢哦烧掉哈，把他扔到海里面哈等等。
Prahlad Maharaj, he never prayed, "Oh Krishna, save me."
Prahlad 大君，我从没有说祈祷哈 ，Oh Krishna, 救救我。
He knows Krishna makararake, Krishna mare rakake. Krishna wants to kill you, no one can save you.
那么他知道哈 ，Krishna 如果想杀你哈，没有人可以来救你。
Krishna wants to save you, who can kill you?
如果的话 ，Krishna 想救你，谁能够杀你
？Therefore, Prahlad Maharaj, he just remembered Krishna.
所以呢 ，Prahlad 大君哈就呢，哦，想着 Krishna.
Therefore, he is the guru of Smaranakya Bhakti.
因此他被称为了 Smaranakya Bhakti 这个代表。
We only remember Krishna when we're happy, but when we're sad, we forget him.
那么我们只是快乐的时候呢，想起 Krishna 哈，伤心的时候记不得哈。
I'm like that. When I'm happy, I.
他说我是这样子的哈，我高兴的时候我想起。
But Prahlad showed how to remember Krishna in all circumstances.
但是呢 ，Prahlad Maharaj 呢，在所有处境中哈都记得。
They tried to chop him.
有人想砍他把他砍碎。
They threw him on the elephant.
把他扔到了这个大象的脚下。
But the elephant smelled him and they became friends with him.
那么的话，这大象呢，闻到他身上的味道哈，成为他的朋友。
They threw him to the snakes.
把他扔到了这个毒蛇哈，这个池子里面。
But Prahlad's influence was so great, even the snakes gave up their envious nature.
那么呢 ，Prahlad 的影响哈这么厉害啊，那么甚至蛇哈都放弃他们后嫉妒哈这个心态。
They gave him poison.
他们哈给他下毒吃。
Prahlad offered to Krishna and drank it, could not affect him.
那么 Prada 哈把这个东西呢供给 Krishna 哈，这个毒药呢不能够影响。
They tried to boil him in oil.
他把他们哈放到油锅里面炸。
Throw him off the mountain.
把他从山上哈推下来。
Burn him.
用火烧他。
But Prahlad was unaffected.
那 Prada 哈一点都不受影响。
Hiranyakashipu was very sad.
Hiranyakashipu 哈很伤心了。
This boy's power is unlimited.
他说这个孩子哈的力量无穷啊。
Sanda Anamaka said, "Don't worry, Maharaj. He's a young boy."
那老师就说了哈，不要害怕 Maharaj， 他只是个小孩子哈，还可以改变。
He's like a green bamboo。
他像一个哈嫩的竹子。
Can be bent this way, that way。
可以随便的哈，好的。
They took him back to re-education。
所以呢哈，再回去再教育。
And they put him back at school, teaching him politics。
再回去呢，让他教他哈，教他政治哈。
Thank you。
好的。
Thank you。
谢谢。
Jnana Timirandasya Jananjana Salakaya Saksur Umilitam Yena Tasmai Sri Gurve Namaha Vansha Kalpatarupyasya Kripa Sindhu Vevacha Patitanam Pavanepyo Vaishnavepyo Namo Namaha. First of all, I offer my humble obeisances thousands and thousands of times onto the lotus feet of my Gurudev Om Vishnupada Paramahamsa Pariyurakacharya Ashtodata Sri Srimad Bhaktivedanta Sri Narayana Goswami Maharaj. I also offer my humble obeisances on in the times unto my Param Gurudev, Srila Bhakti Pratyan, Keshava Goswami Maharaj, Srila Bhakti Vedanta Swami Maharaj, and all our acharyas in the line of Srila Rupa Goswami. I also offer my humble obeisances unto all the Tridandi sannyasis, Vaishnavas, Vaishnavis, all guests who have come here to hear Harikatha. We are very fortunate.
首先我向好去了Guru Day的莲花主顶拜，向所有的Vaishnava，所有来宾顶拜。So
we are very fortunate that you've come here under the guidance of Guru and Vaishnavas. We are receiving the most precious treasure, the Harikatha, which can liberate the living entity from the cycle of repeated birth and death.
那么我们非常幸运在呢，Sri Guru的指导下的话呢，来聆听这些命题Harikatha。那么这些珍贵的教导的话呢，可以让我们从生死这种轮回中呢解脱出来。
This is a very rare opportunity.
这是一个非常罕有的机会。
And now we are hearing for so many days what are the great jewels in this process of Bhakti Yoga.
那么我们这几天都一直聆听了这方面的命题，就是说珍贵的珠宝，在这条奉爱之途上，这些珍贵的珠宝。
Today we are hearing the glories of Sri Prahlad Maharaj.
那么今天我们聆听的是圣 Prahlad Maharaj 这个故事。
What a great devotee he was, how tolerant, how kind, how merciful.
那么他是怎么样的伟大的一位奉献者，如此的容忍，如此的慈悲。
Even his father, the greatest of all demons, materialistic personalities, not at all interested in becoming a devotee, actually envious of Krishna. So Lord, very patiently, he explained what is the real knowledge, what is the real benefit for the living entity.
那么尽管他的父亲是一个恶魔，一个纯粹的物质主义者，对Krishna知觉等等完全没有兴趣，甚至是嫉妒Krishna的人。 但是呢，他非常有耐心地向父亲解释了相关的这些命题，怎么叫呢？父爱等等这些方面的命题。
Nowadays in this society, scientists are making so much endeavor to attain progress in material science.
那么在现在的社会的话，科学家们很努力地想在科学领域进步。
They think very soon they will discover how to never grow old and become immortal.
那么他们还想着怎样子能够不要变老，变得永生不死。
Even in India, they are very bewildered by this materialistic science.
甚至印度这么古老的国家的话，也被深受这种物质科学所迷惑。
But we see here that Hiranyakashipu, he was more advanced materially than any other living entity ever has been.
那么实际上这个恶魔Hiranyakashipu比任何一个物质主义者 任何时间存在过的物质主义者都更为先进的。
We heard from Shripad Padmanabha Maharaj how he had attained immortality.
那么我们从Shripad Padmanabha Maharaj现在听到了，他怎样已经取得了类似于永恒这种东西。
How he was able to reverse the actions of the laws of karma.
他甚至扭转了karma业报的定律。
How he was terrorizing all living entities who wanted to live a religious god fearing life.
那么的话，他甚至去骚扰和恐吓那些想过灵性生活的这些众生。
But he could not control his little son.
但是却控制不了他这个小儿子。
Hiranyakashipu, his mind became more and more agitated.
所以呢，Hiranyakashipu这时候心意越来越受到一种激惹。
Why I cannot control my little boy?
为什么我连这个小毛孩，我的小毛孩。
We heard from Shripa Damodara Maharaj how Sandana and Marika, they pacified Hiranyakashipu. Don't worry, we will take care of this.
那么我们从Shripa Damodara Maharaj听到他的老师安慰他说不要担心，我们会把他弄好。
He is only a very little boy, soon he will change.
他说他只是个小孩子，还可以变。
So after all this took place, Sandana and Marika were teaching Prahlad Maharaj and all his demoniac co-friends, the sons of the demons.
那么呢之后呢随后的话呢他的老师就教授普拉达大师他的这些恶魔的孩子们。
And I thought, oh, Prahlad is listening very well, he's behaving very well, and he's actually making good progress, ideal student.
那么呢他就觉得普拉达大师行为很就是说很好而且呢也很进步是一个非常好的学生。
Whereas Prahlad, he never considered that there was any value in the teaching. He was always meditating on the Supreme Personality of Godhead.
但是的话呢普拉达大君他从来没有觉得他老师教的东西有任何价值总是在内心呢冥想自尊主。
Remembering the glories of the Supreme Lord as he has heard from his spiritual master.
然后呢就说记起他灵性导师讲述的关于自尊主的荣耀。
He had heard for 60,000 years in the womb of his mother the glories of the Supreme Lord.
那么这样呢他呢从他母亲的入肚子里面聆听了呢六万年。
Directly from the lotus lips of Sri Narada Muni.
直接从呢圣哲拿的穆尼口中去聆听这些东西。
So Prahlad was completely absorbed.
普拉达大君是完全的专注其中。
In remembering his Supreme Lord.
完全的冥想专注于冥想的自尊主。
So Swami Ramarika was thinking, oh,He is doing okay. Yeah. Today we have to go for some errands. We will ask Prahlad to monitor all the schoolboys.
那么他的老师呢就说了他的孩子学得很不错。今天我们要他呢就是管理所有的其他的同学做班长。
So I said, Prahlad, you please look after all your school fellow students, and we will come back just after a little while.
那么他老师跟他说了哦普拉德你照看了这个同学我们呢一会儿就回来。
So Prahlad was thinking, this is a golden chance.
普拉德认为这是个黄金的机会。
And all his students, fellow students, they were thinking, now we can play and we can have fun.
那么这些同学就说了现在可以玩了可以大家一起玩。
And they became very excited.
非常的就是说兴奋起来。
But Prahlad said, listen, my friends,
普拉德说听着我的朋友们。
He said, Komara Acharet Pratyo, Bhagavad Dharmam Samyaha, Durlabam Manushya Janma, Sat Api Adruham Arthadam. He said, this material life, human form of life is very rare.
他说这个人生这个人类身体的诞生的话呢是非常罕有的。
And although it is temporary, it can grant us the highest benefit.
尽管如此的这个短暂但是呢它却能够给我们完美这个东西。
What is that highest benefit? It is the pure devotion for the Supreme Personality of Godhead.
那么这个最高的福祉是什么呢就是对自尊主这个呢奉献服务。
The human form of life only allows us to engage in pure devotional services to the Supreme Lord.
那么人生的话呢给我们这个机会呢去做呢对自尊主做这个纯粹的这个奉献服务。
Therefore, my fellow students, use your intelligence. Don't waste any moment. Start at once while you are still young and practice your devotional service.
所以普拉达大君说我亲爱的朋友们不要浪费你们时间了从现在开始从你们呢这个孩童时候开始。
Thus you will be happy in this world and after this life you will always be happy in the eternal service of the Supreme Personality of Godhead.
那么在自尊主永恒的服务之中的话呢不仅呢这世快乐来世也如此。
So his fellow student said, Prahlad, but what about enjoying in this world? We have to learn some profession and we have to earn money in order to maintain our lives.
那么这学生就说了这是 Oh Prahlad, 那享受生活又怎么样呢我们还得学一门技术然后呢可以呢养家糊口。
So Prahlad answered, don't worry for anything, simply engage in devotional service. Already the Supreme Lord is looking after all living entities. He's looking after the animals, after the trees, after everyone.
那 Prahlad 就说了只要呢从事奉献服务就行了自尊主在照顾一切生物那么像动物等等的话呢都没有问题。
So don't make any effort to attain more happiness in this world or try to...Diminish your distress.
所以的话呢不要特别的努力呢去增加你在这个世界上的快乐或是呢减少你的痛苦。
By our previous activities, already this is destined to happen to us.
那么呢只有我们过往的行为的话呢这些东西呢已经是命中注定的。
Whereas if we engage 100% in Krishna consciousness, devotional services,
我们 相反哈，是应该百分之百的精力哈，专注于呢 Krishna 自觉哈，对主的服务。
Any material duality, happiness, distress, beauty, ugly, sick, healthy, rich, poor, man, female, all these dualities.We will easily overcome and we will always be absorbed in devotional services.
那么的话如此的话呢你才能够轻易的跨越哈这个物质双重性哈美啊丑啊穷啊富啊痛苦啊快乐啊男的女的哈等等这些东西。
But Allah, we have heard from our teachers that life is meant for economic development, for sense gratification, for enjoying heavenly happiness and attaining liberation.
那么呢哈，那些学同学呢就说了哈 ，All plus 哈，我们从老师那里听到了，人生的话呢哈，就是拿来哈及时享乐的，就是为了哈经济发展，为了感官享受，为了哈来世的解脱。
They've given so many good teachings in this regard.
哦，这方面的话呢哈，他们给了很多这方面的教导。
So why not follow this and at the end of our life we can perform some devotional service and we can go back to the spiritual world.
他说为什么不可以去学这些教导呢在我们往年的时候我们可以灵修回到灵性世界。
So I said, no, don't worry, yeah, to think that at the end of your life you will engage in devotional service. Just now you should start.
他说呢不要呢想着你年老的时候再去修行了现在就开始了。
He said, suppose, yeah, you may live 100 years.
就像你能活100岁。
Then what will happen?50% yeah, of your life you will waste in sleeping.
他说哦，那又怎么样呢？哈，50%哈，就50年时间哈，就浪费在睡眠中。
And the last 20 years between 1800, you cannot do bhajan.
那么后面20年哈，80到100岁，你根本哈修不了。
You need so much assistance.
你需要很多哈这个帮助才行的。
No, good memory.
哦，记忆力也不好，健忘。
Mind will always be absorbed in what happened in the other part of your life.
那么这时候呢，我真的总想着以前的以前的发生的事情，你自己的儿子、孙子，家里动物，
your house, all your possessions,
家里面的财产，
your friends, your enemies,
你的敌人呢？
No time to do bhajan.
没时间在灵修了。
At once start now.
所以现在就开始。
And what more, yeah? If you think you will be happy by economic development, then what happens? 20 years, the first 20 years of your life, you'll have to engage in study to learn some profession.
所以呢，就算你觉得生命是为了呢经济发展的话呢，那么你前面20年时间也在浪费在学习呢各种职业以然后谋生。
Another 20 years wasted, no time for bhajan.
所以呢这20年又浪费了没有时间做bhajan和灵修了。
Material education cannot give happiness, nourishment for the atma, for the soul.
所以呢这个物质主义的教育的话呢不能够给我们这个灵魂 atma 增加快乐。
The soul is only happy if it engages in Krishna bhajan. So start just now, my friend.
他说灵魂只是因为你做了这个 Krishna bhajan Krishna 灵修才会快乐。所以朋友们从现在开始吧。
So again, the last 50% of our life wasted in sleeping. No time for bhajan while you're sleeping.
所以呢50年的时间已经浪费了就睡觉，没有时间做灵修。
20 years at the end of our life wasted. No time for bhajan. No proper memory.Always engaged in thinking, remembering what happened in our life.
那么后面20年的话呢已经年纪很大了没有精力在从事灵修，总是记起年轻时候发生的事情。
The first 20 years wasted. Then what remains in between? Yeah, some years where we will have to give full attention to our family. Yeah, to enjoy so many social activities. No time for bhajan.
所以呢剩下的时间的话呢我们要照顾家庭啊，还有呢很多社交活动，没有时间再去做bhajan。
But don't think that you should do bhajan at the end of your life. Just now, my friends, you should start.
所以呢，别想着你年老的时候呢再去灵修了哈，从现在开始吧，朋友们。
While you're still young, your memory, your intelligence is very fresh and alert. You can at once understand the principles of Krishna bhakti.
所以年轻时候呢哈，记忆呢非常之好哈，就说呢你什么东西哈一下子就能记得，所以对我们的灵修呢非常有益。
So his friends are blessed.We never heard these things from our teachers. How did you discover this?
那么这些朋友就说了 ，Oh, blood 哈，我们从来没有从老师那学的这些东西哈，你怎么发现这些道理
？How did you attain this realization?
你怎么得到了这方面的觉悟
？So Prabhupada said, Guru Shruv Sudhadanaya, Guru Shruv Sudhada Bhaktya, Sarada Labda Arpanena Cha, Sangena Sadhu Bhaktanam, Ishvara Aradhanena Cha. He said. Guru Shru, Shru Bhaktya, with love and devotion, we should surrender completely to bona fide Gurudev.
他所以哈，就是说呢，以坚定的哈，这个信心的话呢，我们要完全哈皈依呢这个呢哈 Guru。
Everything which we have in our possession, we should offer at His lotus feet.
也就是说呢，我们拥有的一切东西哈，都皈依在他的圣主之下。
Under His guidance, in the association of sadhus, advanced devotees, we should learn how to worship the Supreme Personality of Godhead under the guidance of Sri Guru and Vaishnavas.
所以呢，在他的指导下哈，在 Vaishnava 哈纯粹的 Guru 的这个联谊之中的话呢，我们学习如何哈去崇拜呢至尊主。
So Prahlad explains how he obtained this knowledge, and all the students became very inspired. We want to also practice.
所以普拉达哈向他的同学呢解释的哈，如何呢去达到这一点，做到这些事情哈，所以呢这些同学的哈深受鼓舞，都想行
动。Please, Prahlad, explain us in a very simple way. How can we engage in devotional service?
所以呢他说，哦，普拉达哈，请呢给我们简单的解释一下哈，如何能够呢从事呢奉献服务。
And Prahlad said, very simple. You all listen to me and you repeat me.
所以呢普拉达说哈非常简单哈，你们听着哈跟我说。
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama.I had enough of this Krishna business.
我不要听到哈这些 Krishna 的东西。
I told you if you chant his name again, you're in big trouble.
你再唱他的名字哈，你就要呢，你麻烦了哈。
Where do you get your power from?
你从哪里得来这些力量？
You'll be in big trouble for you. I get my power from the same source that you get it.
他说呢，我得到这些力量哈，从同一个源头哈，你得到那个力量。
Oh yeah.You're always talking about an all-pervading person. Well, Prahlad, I haven't seen him anywhere.
他说你总是谈到那个变玄幻有的人，我没看到他。
Is he in this pillar?
在不在这个肚子里面？
How do you think he's immortal? You're immortal, but really, your aunt is kneeling. He's in this pillar.
他说你以为你是个永恒的。
Well, I'm going to give him one of these.
所以的话呢，听到要劈头的话呢，一瞬间的话被呢主呢一句话给灭了。
Now we are finishing Prahlad Maharaj's story.
那么我们现在结束了Prahlad Maharaj这段历史。
You should always follow Prahlad Maharaj.
总是要追寻Prahlad大君的步伐。
As Prahlad Maharaj left his father, Bhat Maharaj left her mother, Gopi left their husband. All became happy. So those who are giving so many obstacles,In Hari Bhajan, whether they may be son, daughter, husband, wife, anyone,
we should give up them at once and do bhajan. We have come from this world, in this world, only to do bhajan, nothing else. So from today, with more enthusiastic, you should do and go on doing bhajan.
然后呢，普拉德妈妈的时候，最后呢离开了自己的父亲和母亲。那么像牧牛姑娘哈，狗皮们的话也离开了自己丈夫。所以呢，那些将讲将重心哈放在呢法卷哈这个灵修身上的人的话呢，不管哈别人呢是就是说父亲母亲啊，还妻儿子女哈等等的，最后呢哈都要放下来的，因为我们来到这个世界上呢，只是为了呢哈做法卷，就是灵修的。
Sukadeva Goswami told to Parikshit, now you should take some rest and drink water. Oh, I don't like to take water or anything. I'm drinking the nectar of your Harikatha. Please continue. How Krishna came to this world and what are his sweet pastimes I want to hear. And again he began to tell.
那么苏卡丁古舍米当时呢，像帕利西大君说了，他说呢，你现在应该休息一会儿，喝点水。但是帕利西大君就说了，他说我不想喝水，我只想饮下你的这个经典的甘露。那么这时候呢，他就询问，想知道呢 Krishna 来到呢这个世界上这些经历的多少时光。
He told that Brahma, this earth having a form of cow, she went to Brahma and told, I cannot tolerate the weight of these demons. I will go to Rasatal. Oh, then Brahma took Shankar and all demigods and went to the bank of Kshirsagar and he meditated. Krishna and Ariel boy came in his heart that Krishna knows all these things. In proper time he will come.
那么当时那个地球呢，以那个牛的形象，向主普拉玛哈倾诉，他说无法忍受这些恶魔哈，这个地球上这些恶魔的这个重负，想到呢低等星宿去。那么主普拉玛呢，以希瓦神哈其他半神一起的话呢，去到呢蕴藏之阳，Vishnu，阴暗之阳哈，做冥想，想请求呢哈这个呢主的降临。 那么主当然哈位于每个人心中，他也哈知道呢这件事情。There
was a king named Ugrasen in Mathura, and he had a son Kansa. He was very very strong. He was as powerful as so many elephants. How many 10,000 elephants. He present his father, get in prison his father, and took himself the kingdom, and began to create nonsense for sadhus, Vaishnava and others. In the meantime, Krishna came, partly the form of Devaki and fully in the form of Mother Yashoda. He is almighty. At a time he can come and thousands of forms. As this Rasleela, he came lakhs and lakhs forms with one gopi, one Krishna. So he can come in the om of Yashoda Ma and also Devaki Mother, both times. But his Purna, complete in Mother Yashoda. When he took birth in prison from Devaki, the fear that comes will here kill him. So, that boy told in Chaturbhuj form,
400 form,
like 16 years old boy with ornament and everything, that if you are fearing, then take me to Gokul and keep me there. Vasudeva Maharaj did so, and he took that boy to Gokul and kept it on the bed of Mother Yashoda, and take his daughter Jogmaya and return back to Jai. Then Kans wanted to kill her and took his legs and wanted to throw on a
stone.
But she became 8 arms, weapons in her hands. And she kicked Kans and told, you cannot kill me. Your killer has second son, but in any other place. And hearing this, Kans called his attendants, that chief minister, all Zenans, and then he told that, what should we do? They told that within 10 days, after 10 days, in whole Braj, if any baby has taken birth, they should kill. By this, we will kill that boy. After this, Kans sent Putana. And what became? You.
那么当时呢，在南摩托瓦这个地方的话呢，乌格拉县这个王的话呢，居住在这里。他有一个儿子呢，叫康萨。那么康萨的话呢，是非常强大哈，这里面形容他呢，力比万头大象。那么他将自己的父亲投入狱中，强夺王位，并且呢，在哈附近的胡作非为，骚扰呢这些圣哲哈、沙赌和歪师那把们。那么当时呢，Krishna呢，选择在这个时机呢到来，他从呢Devaki母亲的这个胎中。 以不分的形象哈，就是不分的这个形象的话呢，展示，和他全部的这个形象呢，在Yashoda妈妈那里出生。Krishna 是全能的，他也以无量形象，他有可以扩展哈无量的形象，就像在呢 Rasa Lila Rasa 15中呢，每一个牧牛姑娘哈都与呢一个 Krishna 哈共舞，所以呢，他也展示了这些哈，就是说呢，不同的形象，其中一个呢是呢 Vasudeva 的儿子，另外一个呢是呢。 耶稣的儿子，但他最完整的母亲呢是耶稣的妈妈。他从狱中从 Devaki 母亲的胎中出生，他显现的是师弟形象，并且呢一出来哈就16岁大，身上呢是呢饰蟒哈这些呢珠宝饰物以及呢哈佩戴的武器。所以当时他对着父母亲说了，他说如果你们害怕的话，那就把我带到Gokul，所以 Vasudeva 呢就将他呢带到了Gokul。 放在了亚修的妈妈的床边，并且将亚修的妈妈这个身边的这个女儿的话呢，也就是 Yoga Maya 这个化身了，那么呢带回到了狱中。当时康萨哈得知呢孩子已经出生了，所以呢过来呢把孩子的哈揪住孩子的腿，并且呢哈想摔死他。这时候呢 Yoga Maya 展示了八臂形象，然后呢用脚呢踢出哈康萨的头，他说 你杀不了我的，你的敌人呢已经在其他地方出生了。这时候康塔就叫来他的爪牙，其他的这些恶魔，他说我们该怎么办。所以呢他们就设计将十天之内在任何一个地区出生的孩子呢都统统杀掉，以这种方式呢他说我们的敌人一定能够铲除呢我的这个敌人。
What did Putana in Gokul?
Om Jnanam Tumirandasya Jnananjana Salakaya Chakturam Ritam Yena Tasmai Sri Gurave Namah. First I offer my unlimited obeisances in the dust of the lotus feet of my most worshipable Diksha Gurudev. Nitya Lila Pravishta Om Vishnu Pad is Dothiris of the Sri Sri Manchala Bhakti Vedanta Swami Prabhupada.
首先我向我最值得崇拜的提比林逊导师 Nitya Lila Pravishta Om Vishnu Pad as Dothiris Sri Sri Manchala Bhakti Vedanta Swami Prabhupada 的灵化主顶拜。
And the same unlimited obeisances in the dust of the lotus feet of my most worshipable Shiksha Gurudev, Om Vishnu Pad, Astotaras Tata Sri Srimad Srila Bhakti Vedanta Narayan Goswami Maharaj.
我也向我最值得崇拜的 Shiksha Guru, Om Vishnu Pad, Astotaras Tata Sri Srimad Bhakti Vedanta Narayan Goswami Maharaj, 的灵化主顶拜。
To all of our disciplic succession and all the assembled devotees.
也向我们所有师徒传记的这些老师们在座的奉献者顶拜。
So all these past days, since Srila Gurudev came here, he's been discussing the history of various incarnations and pure devotees.
那么在过往的几天里面呢 ，Srila Gurudev 呢讨论到了佛教瓦堂里面提及到的不同的化身，主的不同化身以及他的纯粹奉献者的逍遥时光。
He's not only been speaking, just like I'm speaking and I'm giving information.But when Srila Gurudev has been speaking, he's actually injecting the power of following those teachings in our hearts.
那么他Srila Gurudev呢，不仅是讲像我一样，只是传达一个信息而已。那么他将这些这个化身或者奉献者他们的教导的话呢，这种教导注入我们心中，以让我们能够去得以呢追随。
As the prime atoms emanate from his body into our hearts.
那么当他从他身上这个呢？这种原子散发出来进入我们心中。
So he's been giving us the qualification by his own shakti to understand and follow the teachings of all these great personalities, and at the same time he's been preparing us to hear the beautiful pastimes of Krishna in Vrindavan.
那么他提着他的 shakti 他的能量的话呢，让我们有资格能够去呢。追随这些这教导，并且呢，给一个平台给我们呢，以聆听Krishna的逍遥时光。
He's explained how Krishna took birth from the womb of Mother Yasoda by the prayers of the demigods, and at the same time not took birth but appeared in the prison house of Kamsa before Devaki and Vasudeva in a partial manifestation.
那么他讲到了就是说呢，吉优呢和放神的祈祷的话呢，至尊主 Krishna 的话呢显现了。那么他呢以部分的形象显现在 Devaki 的这个胎中，也以完整的形象显现在呢就是Yashoda妈妈
He's explained how Kamsa, because of hearing an aerial voice that Krishna will kill him in the future, he's now beginning to send so many demons to try and kill Krishna.
那么他解释到Kamsa 因为听到空中这个声音传过来，说 Devaki 的儿子第八个儿子呢将杀死他，所以他派了很多恶魔想呢。
Kamsa made alliance with a powerful demon named Putana.
那么呢 ，Kamsa 与这个恶魔Putana 的话呢，形成了一个联盟。
Putana was as powerful as 10,000 elephants.
经典描述Putana 的话呢，力量就堪比呢万头大象。
Putana was also a witch, and she had the power to ride on a stick.In the air, anywhere she liked.
那么呢，布塔呢也是个女巫一个巫师。那么她可以这个脚踩的一个木棍的话就可以去到任何地方飞的。
In order to keep her within his realm of so that he can get victorious, Kamsa made an alliance with Putana.
所以为了在他的王国里面就是说呢，做常胜将军了。
所以他与布塔拉这个恶魔达成了这种联盟
and sent her to Braj.
把他派往了 Braj 这个地方
Putana, although a great demoness, took the form of a very, very beautiful, lovely young lady.
那么布塔拉虽然是一个恶魔来的女魔，但是呢，她呢采取了一个呢非常美丽的女性的形象来到了Braj。
She was so enchanting looking by her demon powers that all the ladies in Braj were charmed by her, including Mother Yasoda.
那么因为她的魔力，所以呢，她呢令到自己非常富有魅力，所以呢令到呢 Braj 的所有人，包括Yasoda妈妈，都受她的这个这个迷惑。
So they very easily allowed her entrance into Mother Yasoda's house, and she told Mother Yasoda that I want to have Krishna drink my breast milk.
所以呢，她呢轻易的进入了Yasoda他们的屋子里面了，并且呢告诉Yasoda妈妈说，我想给男孩子喂奶。
No.
She
didn't ask. She went right into the room of Krishna, and Mother Yasoda thought, oh, she's a better mother than I am. She's so beautiful. Krishna is so beautiful. So certainly Krishna can drink her breast milk.
所以呢，她没有问的，没有询问的，也收的嘛，而是直接上去呢就抱着孩子。但是也收的妈妈说，她呢比我呢更好，Krishna也漂亮，她也漂亮，她比我更像一个母亲。
But that evil Putana had covered her breast with a very, very deadly poison.
但是这个邪恶的女魔Putana的话呢，在她的乳房上呢，涂上了这个毒汁。
And her plan was that Krishna would drink her breast milk and he would suck the poison and die immediately.
她呢就想着了，Krishna会把这个毒吃下去以后呢，就立即死掉。
When Krishna saw her, he closed his eyes. And our acharyas have given various reasons for that.
那么呢，经典描述到当 Krishna 看见他的时候，他的眼睛是闭上的。那么我们的 acharya 先前的导师们的话呢，对此呢有一个评注。She
was such an evil demoness that it was unbearable to look at her. Also, he knew that she was in the form of a woman, and in the Vedic culture or any good culture. It's very sinful to kill a woman, so Krishna closed his eyes like an innocent baby.
那么就有两种解释的，一种的话，她是女魔来的，所以呢，很难忍受看到这种的这个样子。第二个呢，就说呢，因为她是个女性的形象，所以这表达经里面女人是不能杀的，所以呢 ，Krishna 呢像一个很单纯的小孩子那样把眼睛闭上。Also,
in this way, with his eyes closed, she wouldn't suspect the power of the Supreme Personality of Godhead.
当然了，Krishna闭上眼睛呢，他也就不会呢，察觉到呢，作为尊主的力量在这个小孩子的身上。So
she lifted Krishna into her lap and put her nipple into the mouth of Krishna.
所以呢，他把孩子的抱起来，放在他的怀中，然后呢，将他的乳头就放到他嘴里面。Krishna
is very merciful, as it states in the Srimad Bhagavatam that Krishna gave the position of a nurse. To this great demoness, so who else should I have as my worshipful lord?
所以的话呢，佛教啊，它里面描述到了，Krishna非常仁慈啊，他给这个女魔什么样的位置呢？类似于呢，这个就是说奶妈这个位置给她。所以呢，所以还值得我们的崇拜，就是说呢，这样的仁慈的主，还有谁比他更值得我们崇拜的
？So Krishna happily drank the poison and drank out her very life, and she became a gigantic 12-mile-long demoness.
所以的话呢，Krishna不仅饮下她的乳汁也呢吸掉了她的生命之气，这时候呢现出原形了，是一个12里长的这么一个恶魔和女魔的形象。As
she was sucking out her life, she was calling out, "Leave me, child! Leave me! Leave me!"
那么当她把这个生命之气被 Krishna 吸出来的时候，她就在那里吼叫了，她说，哦，放开我，放开我，孩子。
But she couldn't get Krishna off her breast.
但是呢，他却不能够推开Krishna。
Here is the difference between her, a powerful demoness as powerful as 10,000 elephants, and Mother Yasoda.
那么这里面有一个呢，就是说呢，讲一个区别的话，就是说虽然她是个恶魔，力量呢可以比万头大象，但是呢，另外一个是Yasoda的妈妈。
Mother Yasoda was breastfeeding Krishna when she saw that her milk was boiling over.
那耶稣的妈妈有一次呢也给Krishna喂奶，然后看到的话，家里面的这个锅里面哈，这个奶奶那个牛奶哈已经呢凸出来了。
So thinking that the milk is a much better servant than her, much better mother for Krishna, who can give him rubbery and yogurt and rasagula and so many nice things with its milk, whereas she can only give milk from her breast.
那么的话，想着牛奶比她哈是更好的母亲了，因为这些奶制品可以做成的哈，这个呢酸奶呀，哈，罗斯古拉，还有其他哈这些甜品很好吃的甜品，所以呢，她就哈就说呢，这个奶牛奶能够做比她更好的服务。
She immediately wanted to put Krishna down so that she could go and save the milk which was boiling over.
所以她立即的话就放下 Krishna， 然后呢去呢哈抢救这个牛奶了，因为这个牛奶哈要呢吐出来了哈废了。
Krishna didn't want to be let down. So he was hanging on like a monkey. So she at once put him down very easily. But Putana couldn't do that at all. So Krishna drank her very light, and she became a 12-mile-long demoness. And died and spread herself all over Vrindavan and reached Mathura. One of the reasons that Krishna had come, there are many reasons that Krishna sent in this world, and one of those reasons was to deliver Putana.
那么其中一个原因呢，也是哈拯救了Putana。Who
he was so kind to that he gave her a position as a nurse in Goloka.
那么呢，他非常仁慈的，就赐予这个女魔哈一个位置呢，就是呢在 Goloka 哈这个位置呢，一个奶妈的位置。In
her previous life, Putana was the wife of Bali Maharaj, or the daughter of Bali Maharaj.
然后在前世的话呢，Putana这个女魔的话呢是巴里哈巴里大军巴里这个国王他的女儿来的。
And when Sri Krishna, in his incarnation as Vamandev, came to the palace of Bali Maharaj, he looked so beautiful and so sweet.
那么当时哈，主 Krishna 有个化身是 Vamandev 哈，他是一个年幼的婆罗门的化身，他来到了巴里大君哈这个宫殿里面，他长得哈非常甜美哈，很甜的一个小男孩。That
she thought, I would love to have this sweet and charming boy as my son.
所以呢，这个巴里大君的女儿看到他之后呢，就说了哈，我想要这个很甜、很漂亮这个男孩哈，是我的儿子。But
when she saw that he took a gigantic form as large as the universe and then finally arrested her father, she thought differently.
那么最后呢，她发现呢，这个不是个普通小孩哈，就要展示了他的哈很宏大的这个宇宙形象哈。 他捆绑了他的父亲，这时候呢，他的心态就转变。She
thought, if I ever get him as a son, I would kill him.
他说呢，如果我把他有他做我儿子的话，然后我一定要把他杀了。So
in order to satisfy her desire to have him as a son and to give her that opportunity to try and to give her liberation, that was one of the reasons that Krishna descended.
那么呢，也是给他一个机会，做他的儿子，就让他做母亲了。那么呢， Krishna 显现了。
So although Putana came as a messenger of Kamsa, she was never able to go back to tell the story of what happened.
So Putana 今晚作为Kamsa的这个信使，但是呢，永远没有有机会回去报信给他。
And Gurudev will tell us what happened next.
Thank you.
I think it would be better that tomorrow in morning class and then at 10. Same class, the sweet past tense of Krishna, Dambandhan Lila, fruit seller, and other sweet past tense Krishna should be continued. Nothing else. and evening class I will come and I may speak about Sri Ramchandra because
day after tomorrow Ram Navami.
Ram Navami.
Tomorrow
morning at 7:30 there will be a class given by Sripad Bhattarante Giri Maharaj. We'd like to invite Brajana Prabhu to please come join and myself, or, and the three of us will speak about the pastimes of Sri Krishna as Gurudev has ordered us. And then the class at 10 o'clock by Shamarani Didi, and we'd like to invite Brinda Devi Didi to come and join, and the two of them can speak. And the final darshan with Srila Gurudev will be tomorrow morning at 10. All the remaining devotees from China, from Hangzhou, and all the different cities. Sorry?
We have not taken darshan for them. No need to go send fetch.
Okay. Whoever has not taken darshan from Srila Gurudev can have darshan with him tomorrow morning.
Srila Gurudev ki jai, Srila Bhakti Vedanta Narayan Goswami Maharaj ki jai, Srila Bhakti Vedanta